Okay, let's talk wrestling. We are actually one day away from Survivor Series of 2020. I actually have one rumor about the Undertaker, and then I'm gonna tell you the match cards, and then I'm gonna tell you my predictions. So I'm gonna go ahead and tell you the match cards right now. We got Team Raw versus Team SmackDown. We got 2 5-on-5 traditional tag team matches. Starting off, we have a kickoff show. It's the Dub Brand Battle Warrior between both SmackDown and Raw. And honestly, I'm just going to go ahead and tell you my prediction is that Lars Sullivan might win it. So, yeah. And I'll get back into that a little later on. We got Asuka. She's the Raw's Women's Champion. She will be taking on Sasha Banks, the SmackDown's Women's Champion. We got the United States Champion, Bobby Lashley. He will be taking on the Intercontinental Champion, Sami Zayn. We got the Raw's Tag Team Champion, The New Day. They will be taking on the SmackDown's Tag Team Champion, Street Profits. We got the WWE Champion, Drew McIntyre. He will be taking on the Universal Champion from SmackDown, Roman Reigns, the Tribal Chief. And now the 5-on-5 traditional for Team Raw, we have AJ Styles, Keith Lee, Matt Riddle, Braun Strowman, and Sheamus. They will be taking on Team SmackDown. We got Jey Uso, Kevin Owens, King Corbin, Seth Rollins, Otis. And that will be it. And for the women's 5-on-5 traditional tag team for Team Raw, we got the WWE Women's Tag Team Champion, Nia Jax, Shannon Blazer, Lacey Evans, Lana, and that is 1, 2, 3. And then we got Peyton Rouse also. They will be taking on Team SmackDown, Bayley, Bianca Belair, The Wyatt Scott, Liv Morgan, and Ruby White, and Natalya. So that is the match card for that, for Survivor Series. I will get into my predictions in a minute. I just want to talk about this one rumor that's been going around. Well, actually, I'm going to say that for the last. So here are my predictions. We got Sasha Banks versus Asuka. Now, if you seen SmackDown yesterday, you would have seen that Carmella was constantly attacking. Well, if you seen SmackDown last couple of weeks, you see that Carmella has been attacking Sasha Banks for over weeks now. And honestly, and if you seen Asuka just standing there, maybe there would be a heel turn. I'm not really sure. That's my prediction. I think she would win. For tomorrow's show, I think she would win a point for Monday Night Raw. We got Bobby Lashley versus Sami Zayn, the United States Champion versus Intercontinental Champion. I'm going to have to go with Bobby Lashley on this one. So, in my opinion, Raw has 2, SmackDown's got 0. Now, we got the Street Profits from Team SmackDown versus the New Day from Raw. I'm going to predict that the Street Profits wins that one with the 1 point behind Raw. We got Drew McIntyre versus Roman Reigns. You know Roman Reigns coming out of that with a point. So Raw has 2, SmackDown's got 2. Team Raw, AJ Styles, Keith Lee, Matt Riddle, Sheamus, and Braun Strowman taking on Seth Rollins, Jey Uso, Kevin Owens, Corbin, and Otis. I think, to be honest, that is hard to predict, but I'm going to have to go with, Team Raw for this one, because I feel like they got more muscle and strength. And then for the women's 5-on-5 traditional tag team, I'm going to have to go with Team SmackDown. They got Bayley, Bianca Belair, The Wyatt Squad, and Natalya. Now, I know that Team Raw probably got Nia Jax, Shannon Blazer, but other than that, who else do they have? So I'm going to say that Bianca Belair will be the sole survivor for the women's team. And for Team Raw, we will have... Wait. Actually, I think SmackDown will win for the men's team with Jey Uso being the sole survivor since they want to push him lately. So that's just my prediction. I think it would be SmackDown will take the win with the four. Then we got the Dub Battle Warrior. I think Lars Sullivan will win that Battle Warrior or Big E. Maybe it will be Big E winning the Battle Warrior for SmackDown. So, yes, that is my prediction for that. Okay, let's move on to the rumor about The Undertaker. Now, we know that The Undertaker farewell is set for Survivor Series this Sunday, 30 years on from his WWE debut. Now, we know The Undertaker may not be as cut and dry as most of us expected. Now, I think the rumors are The Fiend is set to attack The Undertaker and set up a match for WrestleMania 37. We know The Fiend never forgets The Undertaker. We know The Fiend never forgets The Undertaker, I quote, this is what The Undertaker says about The Fiend, and I quote, The Fiend is somewhere, he said, The Fiend is someone he wishes he had a little bit of more gas left in the tank for. And then he gave more praise on WWE, The Bunk. He talks about how there's possibilities are limitless because he has really taken his character to the next level. He talks about how it's original and so different from what everybody else do. And it's so thought-provoking and draws emotions from other people. Now, we know Bray Wyatt has dropped the hints in the Firefly Funhouse. He talks about the numbers and when The Undertaker first debuted. And then he said, and I'll quote, I would love to be able to work a program with The Fiend. I mean, my goodness, there's no telling what kind of matches we could come up with, you know, just due to the strength of his character and obviously The Undertaker character. It would have been something else. Now, honestly, I think this should be The Undertaker last match because I don't think he has anything left, but I don't mind seeing The Undertaker and The Fiend at WrestleMania 37. Because it could be something interesting and it could be more about storytelling. But honestly, I thought about what about Randy Orton and The Fiend? Does they not have any plans for those to interact with each other? Maybe later on down the road, maybe he will feud with the Randy Orton, then do Undertaker at WrestleMania since it's a bunch of months away from each other. But that is all I have for you guys. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like and subscribe. If you want to see me do more, and I'll